Hey guys, it's Lara. So I'm gonna be doing a get ready with me video. Why? Because I'm gonna be going downtown. My boys' friend's band called Way to the Sun is gonna be playing, so we're gonna go support them. They're playing with some band called Pelican. Not into Pelican, it's not. I listen to them, I just don't really like them that much. If you do, cool. I don't, whatever. As always, I don't know what I'm doing. I'm just gonna go with it, but I'm gonna go in with New Face. This is their pencil in Slate, which I love. It's their eye pencil. And I'm gonna throw this on. This is an awesome, awesome base color. I love using these. You can literally just do this and like use a brush, use a finger and blend it in. And that could just be your eye color and it stays all day. Or you can use this as a creamy base and it will just grab whatever color you put on top. So now that I've got that kind of on my lid a little bit past the crease, I wanna see, I may take this off. I'm gonna go into this Pure My Little Pony palette. I wanna see what happens if I throw this red on top. I wanna see if it's pigmented enough to do this. Cause then I could get some darker looks out of this palette. So I'm just taking my Studio Gear 25 brush. That's actually pretty decent. And see how the nude stick just grabs it right away? Because it's a cream, it's gonna grab the color. The color is gonna be bolder and then it just lasts longer. So let's just blend this up. Then I'm taking my Studio Gear 34 brush with nothing on it and I'm just gonna blend this out. The color is called Tempest Shadow, by the way. I think we might hit up Koreatown too. Well, yeah, down in Convoy. So I think we're gonna go grab some boba first. And then we're gonna head down to the show. That's actually really nice. Who knew? My Little Pony palette. I'm gonna go in with this shade right here from the Modern Renaissance palette. It's called Tempura with one of my Storybook Cosmetics brushes. And I'm just gonna use this just a little bit to blend underneath my brow. Just blend the colors together. Do you guys like talking and get ready with me videos? Let me know. Here's the thing is like, I don't watch them because my attention span is so short and most of the time they're like talking through it and like telling you about their day or what they're up to. So I can do that. It's just the video gets really long. And to be honest, like IRL, I'm not a big talker.
Talking and not talking. We could not talk or talk forever. And still find things to not talk about.
I'm gonna go back in with this My Little Pony palette. This may have just turned into a makeup tutorial now. I'm gonna go into the Songbird Serenade. I wanna see how dark this comes across with this red. This is that MAC brush that I don't have the number for, but it's really awesome. So let's pop a little bit. See, that's decently dark. It's not like a black, but this is good. I didn't know, I wanted to test out the darker colors in this anyhow. To see if I could use it on the daily basis because I'll prefer the darker ones, but I guess I can. And I'm just blending that into my crease. So before I do underneath my eye, I'm gonna go in with this Makeup Forever color. This is a liner in D12, it is their black. And I'm going to go tight line the top and I'm gonna tight line the bottom. There we go. So now I'm gonna go in with my Dr. Brandt primer. I'm gonna be using one of the little guys because I ran out of the big one. I'm gonna throw this all over my face. And then the foundation that I'm gonna be using after is the Kat Von D foundation in shade 42. And it does have a little bit of a tint, the Dr. Brandt primer. It does darken my skin a little bit, which you might be able to see, you might not because of the lighting. But once you put your foundation on, if you're as pale as I am or lighter, it doesn't affect your foundation. You could totally put your color right on top and it's not gonna make you any darker than you are. I'm gonna go in with the Kat Von D in the shade 42 and my Kat Von D brush. And after that, I'm gonna take my beauty blender, which is dirty, because I used it this morning, and I'm gonna use that to blend everything out. How crazy this looks on camera. It does not look this light IRL. Anyhow, I'm gonna go in with my Tarte Fair Beige color. And I'm gonna go right underneath my eyes. And a little bit here. And here, because I'm breaking out right now. And a little bit over here. I'm just gonna take the Beauty Blender and blend those out. I'm watching Facts, by the way. That's what I'm doing, like, while I'm gonna, like, speed this up or decide what I do and put, like, music behind it, is I'm watching the Facts channel, if you haven't watched this, and right now they're trying different teas. Using the Kat Von D patter in shade 42 as well, I am going to take a brush. This is an It Cosmetics brush, number 315. Oh, and the brush that I was using for the Nude Stick. That was also from It Cosmetics. I don't see a number on it, but it looks like this. I think it was like a concealer brush or something. But I'm gonna grab the powder and press it into the skin. I'm gonna take this Nude Stick. I'm gonna apply that under my eye. So I got these Derma Blend drops that are like gnarly pigmented. They're completely brand new. Studio Gear number 35 brush. And they're too dark. They're way too dark for my skin. So I think I'm gonna try that in here and see if I can darken this Kat Von D shade up just a smidge. It's almost there. The problem is, like you can see with my hand, my hands are really tan compared to the rest of my body, but this is too pink. I need something with just, my skin's very neutral, so I need something that has more yellow. And that was the problem with the Derma Blend, is that it was way too yellow. So maybe they'll work together beautifully. And do you see how that just instantly smoked that Nude Stick? That's why I'm saying you could literally just do this, blend it in, and you'd have a smoky eye, like, instantly without any other products, which I think is awesome. All right, going back, same brush, number 35, into this Tempest Shadow from My Little Pony, which is the red, and just going right back on top. You kind of want to like press at first and then blend it, because you want to stick it to the cream and then blend it and soften it out. I had to go through all of my grays to see a color that I could make match, and I think this is going to be the best option, and that would have been really boring for you guys to watch, but it ended up being, it's a lip pencil from ColourPop, and it is called Petite 4. So mine's gnarly dirty, but whatever. It looks like this, and I was trying different brushes and stuff, and it went on best with the It Build-A-Brow brow pencil, so I just kind of threw that on, and I let it go. I've used lip liners as eyebrow pencils tons of times. Most of the time, that's what I use, so we'll see how well this one lasts throughout the evening, but the color, I think, is pretty spot on. Using some Inglot stuff here. I always put the numbers and stuff because they're underneath. Maybe I should write them on the bag. I don't know. On my Instagram. So if you want to see the exact numbers that these are, I always post the looks that I do on Instagram. So I'll post that. I'm going to go in with this bronzing color in this from V's Favorite Brushes. This is the round powder brush. And I'm just going to use that to kind of darken this up a little bit. Because it's going to be late at night and everything, I'm going to put on way more than I normally do. Yeah, you know, we'll put it here too. Just because this color is a little bit light. And this will darken it up a little bit. There we go. Ooh, we gotta blend that. It's fine. For blush, I'm gonna use this color, the darker one. And this is a Studio Gear number 13 brush. And I'm just gonna... These are gnarly pigmented. If you've never used Inglot stuff before, everything from Inglot is insanely pigmented. I love them. I've been using their stuff since they ever had launched. So, since they first started, so I'm just gonna tap this on for blush. One, but it's the same number 13. I'm gonna go into this. This is what I use as like my highlight color. It's actually more my skin color, but I'm gonna take this and go right here to blend this. That kind of softens and blends all this together. And right here to kind of blend these colors together here. So we're just going to take this and blend down. I decided to go with Slayer because why not? And if I'm not going to be at a metal show, at least I'm going to wear metal something. So I put Slayer on here and I just did some mascara. I use this Voluminous Manga Mascara. It's waterproof. So I threw that on. It's fine. And then I am going to do... We'll do this. I'm going to do black lips. So I'm going to do... This is from Black Moon Cosmetics. It is my favorite black lipstick, and it actually stays all day, which I'm pretty stoked for. It's called Sleepwalker. And I'm going to line my lips with that same black liner that I use in my eyes. This is from Makeup Forever again, and that's that black. We are done. My battery is about to die, so I'm gonna go ahead and take my hair down. I need to do it, and I need to get dressed real quick, but I just wanted to show you the finalized look. I think it all came out really well. So yeah, then I'll try out like the cover effect, or not the cover effects. I'll try out like the drops and everything I was talking about, but this is it overall. Let me know what you guys think. If you have questions, I don't know. Whatever, you can always leave them down below. Don't forget to subscribe so you can see more videos like this. You can also follow me on all the social medias. Links are always going to be in the description at the end of the video. And now I have just enough time to get changed and go. All right, I'll see you guys all later. Bye.